Hey guys, so I haven't made a video for a while, so just show you guys our new project car. We have another one, I guess. So Easton's been bugging Dad, or not really, but been bugging Dad. He said something to me a few times about wanting Dad's 71 Dart Swinger. It's 318 car. It's a pretty clean car. It's complete. But anyway, Easton's been saying something about he's been wanting it and asking about it and everything else. So the other day we were talking about it. And Easton's selling his four-wheeler. And he wanted me to ask Grandpa, my dad, what he'd sell him the dart for. Because my dad's got another dart swinger. And this car's just kind of been sitting in the garage for, like, I don't know, a year and a half, 2 years or so. So anyway, I was telling my dad about Easton's going to see if he'd take $2,500 for the dart when he sells his four-wheeler. And Dad's like, sell. He's like, I'll just give it to him. So he gave Easton a dart, and Dad was talking about even giving him a 340 to put in a dart. It's got a 318 with a 904 in it right now, but Grandpa was talking about giving him a 340 to put in it as well. But we'll go ahead and show you the car here. Here's Easton. He's been working on it, messing with it, but it's complete. We got all the sheet metal and hood and everything else for it. It's 318 two barrel. Car was originally gold, but it's pretty good, clean, straight old car. Had a vinyl top, so the roof's got some bad spots in it, but we don't have a front seat, actually, so it's not complete. We took some lacquer thinner to this door panel there and over on the other side, I'll show you, but we took some thinner to this door panel here just to strip the paint to see what the interior looks like. But I mean, the car just, it's a good old car. This is the bad spot. The inner quarter's kind of bad too. We'll probably end up replacing the inner and the whole outer quarter because it's got some rust up there and around the wheel well. So we'll probably end up putting a quarter on this side. As well. We got all the stainless and everything for the car and all the trim in the trunk. The interior is actually not that bad, other than, of course, there's no carpet in a car until it's been sitting in a barn. That door panel is probably the worst of it. But you're just messing around with thinner, just seeing what all they dyed and everything else. And it's actually a factory AC car too. And paint's been flaking. Well, I mean, you can see the paint just flaking off that right there. There's front valance, mirror, bumper brackets, headlight buckets, all the stainless, all the chrome, headlight, or the fender extensions, trim pieces, but I mean, the deck was just essentially gonna rust. See, that's where the go wing goes.
Yeah.
That's what those holes are for. But it'll be a good, fun little project for us. We, you got the keys?
Yeah.
Okay. It's got points, so we're going to see if we can't get this. Grandpa wants us to see if we can get this 318 running, because if we can get it running, and if it sounds good and everything else, we're going to yank this motor and tranny, and we're going to put a 727 in it with another 340 that Grandpa has. So check this out. I find this a little odd. So the car's got manifolds on it. And if you look at the bolts and stuff, clearly the manifolds have been on it forever. Keep in mind, this car hasn't been on the road since 89. It was parked in 89. But look at this. It's got manifolds, but it's got an oil filter adapter on it. So, I don't know. I just find that a little odd. So, actually, Grandpa and Grandma are pulling in the driveway right now. So, and then here's Dad's other 340. It's a 416. That's the one out we took out of the CUDA to put the numbers matching motor back in. And then there's a 727. So, well, let's see what Grandpa and Grandma are doing. All right, guys, we'll be back with you here after a bit. All
right, we gotta trim this wire. Doing some hot wiring right now, just to see if we can't get this thing to hit. I told him we'd do it tonight. Probably have to redo it tomorrow. I don't even know if this thing's in time. I don't know nothing about it. So, I'm just gonna go with it. Well, we don't have enough power. It rolls over. Seems like it's got compression. 13.1, that thing ought to be just spinning. It's kind of weird.
All right, so we're back out here on Dart. We got some stuff rigged up here. We got a Honda Civic battery in it. We're missing some of the wiring, headlight harness and the other part of the harness. So what we did is we are just running power straight to the coil from this wire here, running straight power straight to the coil. We did change the coil because we weren't getting any spark or anything out of the coil. So I went to my grandpa's house and he had a brand new coil in a box. So we grabbed it, Easton got it hooked up. I was checking to see if we have spark because this thing still has points distributor in it. Now, if you watch, you can hear it too. But she's got some spark right there. There she's popping. There we go. So, technically, we're going to try starting this thing with our carburetor. It's not ideal. I can't find a tube barrel over at my grandpa's house. I don't know where in the world he did with the one off the 318 that he has. So we're going to just put some fuel down the intake and see if we can't get this thing to hit. To the best of my knowledge, it's not been started up since 1989. So we'll see. The plugs, haven't pulled them. We're just going to try it out and see what happens here. So with a little luck, maybe we can get this thing going.
Floor fans aren't that bad. Got some surface rust back there. Just like most Mopars, the wiper bushings are probably leaking. Normally what causes all this rust, the water runs down the firewall and just sits right here
from those bushings right there being bad. Don't know if that's for sure what it was, but that may have been what it was. Easton's getting the carpet or the floor pan swept out. We're going to probably start cutting the front floor pan out on this side, that side. I'm going to put rust converter down in the cross member. We got it vacuumed out and stuff. Do the same on the frame rail. Then we're going to drill some spot welds because the floor pan, the floor pan's actually spot welded here. If you see, there's
ball there. There's another one up here. So now we're probably not gonna, I'll just grind it down, pull the whole floor pan off that section, the whole front half, place the front half. Cut this quarter off. We want to look, see how much a quarter panel is. You kind of don't have a very good budget right now. And then, not sure what we're going to do about the roof yet. We're going to pull the back glass out first. But what's crazy is this quarter panel is like perfect. And it's the original quarter panel. It's got some rust there and there, there. But the rocker is pretty good. Got a little baby hole there we'll have to take care of. Just seal it. Just reseal that. That striker on this side's good. Of course, Mopar A body. The other side's been. Oh, there's a hole. Is that a hole? Alright, so we found a little hole there. There, we'll have to put a floor pan in the back section. We might end up doing just put a full floor pan on this side. Except part is it's a front. Yeah, we might just put a full floor pan on this side, or just maybe. I don't know. What are we going to do? We'll figure something out. Factory air car. Missing all the AC stuff, of course. This. Huh. Easton, your glove box is intact.
What's in there?
Nothing's empty. But it's intact. Dash pad's got one crack right there. I think I have two of these at my mom and dad's house. The headliner. For the time being, we're going to push this up. Oh shit. I'm going to put that up like that. And we're going to just black duct tape it for the time being for him. But, I mean, the door shut pretty good on this side. The other side, the reason the striker got ripped out, I'm assuming. And, if it's been smacked on this side some years ago. But anyway, we're going to probably take that all out, find a good one, weld it in, maybe put a brace on the back side. But the reason that striker is ripped out is because lower door hinge. It's bad. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Door moves up and down. And like normal Mopar A body, the striker rips out. The front balance, we're going to have to straighten it out. It's got, I don't even know, we might find a new one.
It's a lot of rock.
Yeah, it's a lot of rock, actually. But he's got the bottom part of the seat out. Took steel wool to the bumper right there. Actually, cleaned up pretty good. Hit another part there. Looks pretty good too. It's another header panel. The trunk, I'm not sure what kind of shape the trunk's in. But this car's got the original quarters on it still. Yeah, this car's got original quarters still on it. All right, so we're back to working on the dark. Well, Easton wanted to pull it out and wash it, so we threw the hood on it. We have the front bumper and everything for it too, and front valance and headlight buckets and all the trim. But Easton wanted to work on it, so we went ahead and we pulled it out. And looks like the wiper bushings are leaking. That's probably why the floorboards rusted out. I said that there the other day. Usually that's why these things rust out here. Back floorboard's pretty dry.
well, pretty clean. It's kind of wet now. We sprayed the trunk out. I had Easton pull the body plugs out, but here it is. The hood's not shut all the way, so we just threw it on there anyway. But this is it. We went ahead and sprayed the trunk out. It was just absolutely filthy dirt, and I told him we'd spray the trunk out of it, just be easier. But that's his dart. Going to the trunk is actually pretty solid. Oddly enough, somebody just looks like they rattle canned it black when they painted the car. It does have a couple pinholes. It's got one there, a little one there. I thought there was another pinhole down in the wheel well. What's crazy about this thing is how it's rusted, because look at the fuel tank straps, brackets for the fuel tank straps. They're like perfect. Frame's in pretty good shape, just surface rust. Little baby rear end, but it's got old school shackles on it, which we'll be taking those off probably, unless he wants back end jacked up. It does have some rust right there that we'll have to fix too. But all in all, I mean, the deck lid's pretty solid. Make him a good little car, so he's really wanting to get at it. So he's got some money saved up for mowing yards, and I think we're going to go ahead and start with the floor pans. We're going to start with floor pans and get the cross member cleaned up on the inside, and that front frame rail cleaned up, and start with it. We're going to get the glass pulled out of it. What color are you painting this thing?
I don't know.
What color do you think?
Orange.
Huh?
Orange or purple?
Orange or purple. Yeah. Alright guys, so you heard him. Put down what color you think he should paint the car. He's kind of torn. He likes the white stripes. He thought about doing... You were wanting to do plum crazy purple with a white tail stripe, weren't you? With white interior? So, let us know what you guys think, what color he should paint the car. That's probably going to be one of the most expensive things to do to this car is buy the paint for him. But he's selling his four-wheeler, so once it's sold, he'll have a bunch of money. And, of course, we'll probably help him out, and Dad will probably help him out. Dad said something about maybe giving him a 340 for the car. So, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what happens. First thing to do, though, is get the sheet. I want to get the sheet metal work done before we do anything. And we're going to get the motor and tranny pulled out of it, get the engine bay stripped down. We're probably just going to strip it down to bare metal because the engine bay has been painted, and it looks like they just like rattle cammed the engine bay black on it as well. So we'll probably just strip it down to bare metal. The car, we're going to strip it down to bare metal as well. Some of the spots don't look like they sanded it before they painted it. Like if you look here, the door jamb, it's still shiny. So, and I'd like to address that. I really want to fix that. I mean, they kind of fixed it how I've seen a lot of people fix them. Just weld the washer to the door jamb. Normal A-body Mopar stuff, ripping the striker out. But the rear bumper, after the car's painted, I think we're just going to roll with that bumper some. I think it'll clean up pretty good. I'll take some mother's polish or something to it. I haven't priced a rear bumper. We talked about putting a 70 rear bumper on it though too, so I'm not sure what we're going to do. But get the floor pans fixed on it, and then get the quarter panel, get this quarter panel cut off. There's a bunch of Bondo in this one. I think the car was hit on this side, if I had to guess. And they fixed it, and this might be why they decided to repaint the whole car. I don't know. The roof, of course. I think it's got some, I thought it had pinholes. Yeah, someone put something, right there. But the roof's in there, and it's got some pinholes. Of course, if you look, there's a couple pinholes. I'm assuming that's probably rust. Yeah, that's rust. We may just see about getting, we can find a full quarter. Maybe just throw a full quarter on it, and that'd take care of a lot of this rust issues here. This is like inner tube, bicycle inner tube or something, ain't it, Easton? But let us know what color you guys think he should paint the car. I'm leaning towards plum crazy, but at the end of the day, it's his car, and he can paint it whatever color he wants. So, McKenna's in here singing dance, dance, dance. I don't know what that kid's doing. Have you ate dinner yet? Yeah, I know, you're eating chips. Anyway, we're going to get back at it. Get this thing dried off. We're going to vacuum out the trunk, get it dried up. He's got the leaf blower, going to take it to the trunk as well. And get it back in the garage. So, you guys will have to continue watching, see what we do next. Hopefully the next thing we do will be cutting a quarter, getting the floor pans out of this thing. Get that stuff done. I've not hung a quarter for probably, I've not replaced a quarter panel or redid a quarter panel for probably, I don't know, 25 years, give or take. So it's going to be something I've not done for a long time. So I don't know, it may not look the greatest, but we do everything ourselves, or as much as we can. Something else, if anybody is Ohio, Kentucky, Pennsylvania, West Virginia way, and if you guys got any parts for this car, please let us know. You want to put bucket seats in this one, don't you?
Yeah.
He wants to do bucket seats. So if we can round up a set of bucket seats, that'd be awesome, because that's pretty much the only thing on the interior that we're missing, actually, is seats and carpet, of course. But carpet, we're going to buy new. But for some reason, the car don't have the bench seat in it anymore. So I'm not really sure what happened to it. But it wasn't in there when my dad got the car. It had the back seat and no front seat. So, yeah, if you guys got any parts, let us know. We might be interested in them. And hope you guys enjoy. And please follow along and see what we do with this thing. And give any pointers to hanging quarters, because I've not done it forever. So we'll see what happens. So hope you guys have a good evening. Thanks. Goodbye.